Meanwhile, new criticism of the president's handling on Syria coming from two former members of his administration. At a forum, former defense secretaries Leon Panetta and Robert Gates both said it was a mistake going to Congress for permission, and they were skeptical about the deal with Russia. But that's where the agreement ends. Panetta's a Democrat, supports a military strike, said, quote, when the president of the United States draws a red line, the credibility of this country is dependent on him backing up his word, end quote. Wyoming Senator John Barrasso, chairman of the Senate Republican Policy Committee, has been critical on this issue as well. And, sir, welcome here. You've got two former defense secretaries now. What did you think of their stance?
Well, what they agree on is that we had no strategy with regard to Syria. The president did not make a compelling or a comprehensive push to the American people about why this was in the best interest of America, why this was a threat to our national security. I agree with them, however, that you cannot trust the Russians. When President Obama pushed the reset button with Russia, I don't think anybody knew that he was handing over the car keys and now we'd have Vladimir Putin behind the driver's seat.
But both say he should not have consulted Congress. I think his own advisors were even of the same opinion. Do you believe that Syria should have been hit for a period of hours or even days without consultation with Congress? Would you have supported that?
No, I voted against using military force against Syria. I do not think Syria is a threat to the United States. I think the president clearly didn't know his own mind because I think he got cold feet after the British Parliament voted against supporting David Cameron. And David Cameron said, hey, the British people are not going to go and attack Syria with you. So the president, I think, changed directions in midstream, zigged and zagged back and forth. And that's why I think that he does not have the support of the American people for an attack on Syria.
Then it appears to me that you would agree with Robert Gates then when he said the following at that forum, quoting now, I believe to blow a bunch of stuff up over a couple of days to underscore or validate a point or principle is not a strategy. What did you make of that?
Well, I agree with the former Secretary of Defense. That is not a strategy. I still think we do not have a strategy. I don't think that this program being driven by Russia to keep Assad in power is going to be successful. I think it's an effort to buy time by the Russians as well as by Assad. And I don't think that this is going to result in the sort of things that the president hopes for in terms of accounting for, identifying, and removing all of the chemical weapons from Syria.
I tell you, from this vantage point, it seems like the issue is just disappearing and dissolving slowly. You know, it's out of the headlines. But what Gates said is what you should do is the following. Arm select rebel groups, take away his bank accounts, label him a war criminal, and put pressure on him that way. Did you support that?
Well, I think that is a very thoughtful approach. There'd be a lot of support for that effort. The question is, who are the vetted rebels that are the ones that kind of can successfully push the case? But if you're trying to remove the chemical weapons, which is what this relationship and agreement with Russia calls for, it almost calls for Assad to stay in power to make sure that those chemical weapons get transmitted. So that's why I believe that this arrangement is set up by the Russians to keep Assad, who they sell a lot of weapons to, in power to buy time. And I think any agreement with the Russians is going to, that Vladimir Putin is going to want a high price from the American people and from this president
though,
to continue along.
You still have this red line comment out there. And what Panetta says, quote, once you draw a red line, damn it, his words, you've got to do it. For Obama not to back up his words with a strike would embolden Iran on nuclear weapons and other American enemies.
Well, the president put himself in his own box by drawing this red line over a year ago. Many of us on the Hill said we thought it was a mistake to draw that red line. And, you know, we had a meeting with Secretary of State Kerry yesterday in the Foreign Relations Committee, a secure briefing. But in the advice that he asked of us, he heard from both sides of the aisle that if a vote was brought to the Senate and to the House today to Congress on whether we should strike Syria, the vote would be against supporting the president.
Senator Barrasso, thank you for your time. I know you wrote on this topic about a week ago, and we'll see where it goes, if anywhere, and whether or not you can trust the Russians. Thank you, Senator.
Thank you, Bill.